Professor Fig and Weasley have asked that I teach you an additional defensive spell. Please complete the assignments I have given you, and then proceed to see me in my classroom.
Imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Lumos.
And the boys don't make it any easier.
Handy.
Revelio.
Onion again.
Good morning, Professor Garlic.
How wonderful it is to see you again, Lenora dear.
Oh, here. You'll need these for today's class. A little treat for your auntie.
Ah, hello. Class, please welcome the newest rose in our garden. We do look forward to growing together. It is to have everyone back together again. This year will be filled with enchantment and excitement, but the most important thing cultivated in herbology is knowledge. The prudent herbologist is no more afraid of the venomous tentacular than the bouncing bulb. Now then, today we will be acquainting ourselves with the mellifluous tuber known as the mandrake root. Accio! Let's see if we can't make our fibrous friends a bit more comfortable, shall we? First, let's protect our ears. Now, everyone, grip their mandrake by the tendrils and give it a firm tug. Should envelop the root like a warm, dirty blanket, putting the mandrake right at ease. Reparo! I'm very sorry about that. Yours was a bit mature, I'm afraid. All right then, off you go. Splendid work, everyone. Now, for our next task, we'll be planting Dittany at our potting tables.
I wonder if hippogriffs like knotgrass.
Yes, Professor.
Firstly, well done with your mandrake. They can be rather difficult to get a grasp of.
Actually, I enjoyed it. I couldn't help but catch your enthusiasm.
How kind of you. It seems you're already taking to herbology like a mandrake to fresh soil. Now, as I mentioned, next we'll be planting Dittany. Let us find you some seeds.
I already have some, Professor. Pick them up in Hogsmeade.
You visited the Magic Neep. Wonderful! A prepared student is bound to bloom. I've arranged for you to have your own potting table here in the classroom. Wasn't easy to spare one on such late notice. Plant the seeds there now, and you can return to harvest them later. Even with soil, sunlight, and a bit of magic, they will take time to grow.
Let's see how to balance my star thistle.
Dittany's restorative properties make it a vital ingredient in the Wiganwell potion, as you all should know from Professor Sharp's class. Well done! Once it can be harvested, your Dittany will be ready to use in Wiganweld potion. I'll let Professor Sharp tell you about that. Now, what say we branch out? Introduce you to a different sort of flora, the Chinese chomping cabbage.
You'll find that some plants are better suited to uses outside of a cauldron.
The cabbages do get testy without something to chew. Fortunately, I have a dummy for them to gnaw on. Be a dear and let them have a good chomping.
Yes, Professor.
They're in the other greenhouse. It's just at the end of the footbridge leading out of this room. Your classmate, Mr. Pruitt, has kindly offered to accompany you. Come back and see me when you're finished. Oh, and mind your fingers. They do bite.
Hello. Saw you on your way to Hogsmeade the other day. Nice work in Defense Against the Dark Arts, by the way.
Excuse me?
Your duel with Sebastian. And he's good. Thinks he's really good. But you outright slaughtered him. It was brilliant.
Oh.
Here we are. Home of the Chinese chomping... Now, see that dummy? Just toss the cabbages at it, and they'll do the rest. Look at that! They'll chomp on anything they can get their mouths on. Mum planted some in her garden last year to keep the gnomes out. Did save her the denomies, but they left her honking daffodils in tatters. Vicious little bastards, aren't they? My kind of plants. Not like stupid booba tubers and bouncing bulbs. The kind of plants that'd have your back in a fight. Not saying you can't go it alone, but, well, imagine that wasn't a dummy.
Trust me, Leander. I was imagining it the entire time.
You were? I mean, of course, you're not someone to be trifled with. I see that. Dogweed and Deathcap has more of them, if you're keen. Other plants too. Ones your parents wouldn't plant in the garden. You get the idea. Anyway, we probably ought to head back to class. Take your time. I'll see you back in class.
Reminder as to why we should always wear our dragonhide gloves. I shall end our lesson here.
I tended to the Chinese chomping cabbages, Professor.
Remarkable plants, aren't they? I hope they weren't too much trouble. Oh, don't see any bite marks or missing digits. And good, as you do seem to be quite green-fingered. Oh, I'm eager to see your skill in the soil continue to blossom.
Magical plants have so much to offer. I'm eager to learn more.
I'm glad. Herbology is a bounteous subject. Tend to your garden, and it will tend to you. Huh. Well, I suppose that's everything. Do come by for a chat sometime. I so enjoy checking in with my new students.
Those mandrakes are really relishing their new pots. Only cost me my damned hearing.
Understand. That goes for plants as well as friendships. Kindness and concern are as necessary.
Rebellion. Rebellion. Incendio. Revelio.
Shouldn't there be auras or someone from the ministry guarding the school?
Professor Black would never allow that. It would make him look completely incompetent.
Potions is one of the most challenging and hazardous subjects taught at this school. As fifth years, you will be required to reach new heights of both discipline and intellect. You will begin this term by brewing a Wigan Weld potion. Mr. Takar, can you tell us why this particular potion might come in handy?
Yes, Professor Sharp. The Wigan Weld potion can be used to sterilize and even heal a variety of injuries.
It can heal some injuries, but not all. Points for Ravenclaw. Before today's class is completed, each of you will have brewed a Wigan Weld potion of your own. You never know when you might need it. Please begin. Use a strong, even motion when crushing your ingredients. Please be meticulous when adding powder to your potions. One errant sneeze could be disastrous. I see most of you have not forgotten how to stir. Not an easy potion to brew. Well done. And from what I hear of your recent exploits in Hogsmeade, you'd also do well to practice brewing the defensive Edurus potion. Professor Weasley had you acquire the recipe from J. Pippin's, correct?
Yes, sir.
Good. For the moment, you can find the ingredients you need in my office. But in the future, you'll be expected to provide your own ingredients. Some can be harvested from the plants you grow in your herbology class, and rarer ones can be purchased. Others, however, may be harder to obtain and will require you to be a bit more resourceful. Come and see me when you've finished brewing, and we'll see if it was skill or luck the first time around.
My parents considered keeping me home from school this year after the rumors of a goblin rebellion.
Professor Sharp said that Wigan Weld potion can treat injuries. Hope I never need it.
Professor Sharp must have learned a lot during his time as an Auror. I wish he talked about it more.
Did I hear Professor Sharp say that you have permission to go into his office?
He did say that. He wants me to get more ingredients to brew another potion.
Brilliant! You, my friend, have been presented with an extraordinary opportunity. You remember me, don't you? Gareth Weasley.
Ah, yes. We met in the common room.
Listen, anyone with a troll-sized brain can brew an Edurus potion. I'm working on something that's certain to be spectacular. I'm just missing one tiny last ingredient that will add that extra spark.
I suspect that's where I come in.
You're as clever as I'd hoped. I simply need a single Thwooper feather. As you'll already be in Sharp's office with his permission, perhaps you could grab it for me.
I'll get you the Thwooper feather, as long as you're certain Sharp won't miss it.
I assure you he won't. Thwooper feathers aren't that valuable. Wait until you see what I'm brewing. Hurry back to me when you have the feather.
Your potion should remember, precision is key when brewing.
Here's the flopper feather you wanted.
Brilliant! Thank you. This is going to take a moment to brew. You should get back to brewing your Endurus potion, and I'll tell you when this concoction's finished.
Proficiency in potions are two things that cannot be rushed. Have patience and be thorough.
And now we add the mallow sweet, and that's odd. What's happening? Wait, it's not supposed to.
I was impressed that you were able to answer Professor Sharp's question about wicked corruption.
Oh, you're the new student. I've heard much about you. Thank you. I'm Amit, by the way. Pleasure, truly. And I've never seen anyone brew such a flawless Wiggenwald potion on their first try. Well done.
I'm glad I was able to get it right the first time.
You must simply have a knack for potion making. Some students seem so confounded by potion recipes, it's as if they're written in gobbledygook. A fascinating language, by the way. Neither here nor there, really, but I am a self-taught speaker. Merlin's beard, good conversation is the enemy of free time. I must return my book, Gateway to the Far Stars, before my next class. Speaking of stars, we'll be in astronomy together. You'll love it. Professor Shaw is firm, but quite clever. See you soon, no doubt.
I brewed an Endurus potion as you asked, Professor.
I'm surprised you had the time. You seemed rather busy helping Mr. Weasley brew chaos.
I'm sorry, Professor. I was merely trying to help a friend.
Taking responsibility for one's actions does go a long way with me. I shall assume that you've learnt a lesson. As for the work you did today at your own cauldron, I will say you've done well. I confess I was skeptical given the advanced nature of this class and the fact you're a new student.
I'm glad I was able to meet your expectations.
A rare occurrence. And you do well to remember that you're not a potions master quite yet. In addition to having a solid grasp of how to combine various ingredients, you should gain an understanding of the ingredients themselves. Pay particular attention in herbology. The plants you nurture there are often essential to the potions you brew here. Now, I recommend that you find a safe location in which to practice brewing. You cannot leave a hot cauldron simply anywhere. That'll be all. I think each of us has had enough excitement for one day.
Ugh, my robes are going to reek. Now, was it 2 pinches of
Revelio?
Ah!
Revelio.
This looks intriguing.
It is good to see you, my friend.
Hello, Natty. How are you? I hope you've recovered from our rather eventful trip to Hogsmeade.
I am well, but I have been worried about you, my friend. With Ranrok and Rookwood and Harlow after you?
I'm all right at the moment.
We did not speak about it at the time, but I am hoping now you might tell me why they were looking for you.
They want something that Professor Fig and I found at Gringotts.
When were you at Gringotts?
Just before we came to Hogwarts. In fact, it's why I was late to the sorting ceremony. A portkey brought us there after the dragon attacked our carriage.
What on earth?
There's one more thing. It's a bit odd, if I'm honest. Professor Fig says I have a rare connection to a powerful form of ancient magic.
Is that the magic you used fighting the trolls in Hogsmeade?
I think so. I'm still learning, but I can see traces of it, and I've cast magic I can't otherwise explain. I know that's a lot to absorb.
It is. And I will have more questions. For now, it is safe to say that Rookwood and Harlow are a threat to both of us, to all of us. Which is why I wanted to speak to you. I realized something that day in Hogsmeade. You displayed such courage fighting that troll, and Serona wasn't intimidated one bit by Rookwood and Harlow. Both of you have inspired me to take a stand of my own.
What sort of stand?
Men like Rookwood and Harlow are the reason my mother and I left Matibililand. I am not going to sit by and watch them destroy my new home.
Good. Rookwood and Harlow are a dangerous pair. And the fact that they're working with Ranrok, well...
All the more reason they must be stopped. Rumor has it that Theophilus Harlow runs Rookwood's day-to-day operations. Taking him down would cripple Rookwood's entire enterprise.
That may be true, but shouldn't Officer Singer handle someone like Harlow?
I spoke with her. She was polite, but perhaps understandably would not discuss details with a student. I overheard some of Rookwood's lot talking about a massive poaching operation that Harlow is planning. I was thinking that we could investigate a bit, try to get the evidence that Officer Singer needs.
All right, but how?
I am going to watch and listen, find out precisely what Harlow is up to. I shall reach out when I know more. In the meantime, remember, I am here if you need me.
Thank you, Natty.
Be on your guard.
How nice to see you.
Revelio.
I beg your pardon. How dare you threaten me?
What's going on here?
Some assistance.
They must have come this way. Think!
I've no idea who it is you think I might have seen. I've been busy with my research. I do not have time to...
Victor Rookwood, don't give a doxy's nip back your time. Oi! Speak of the devil. Mr. Rookwood would like a word with you.
Students, you can't be
sick. Enough out of you.
Leave her alone.
Stupefy!
Stupefy!
Let me go.
Think you're clever, don't you?
I'll watch the light go out of your eyes. just happened? I've never been accosted in such a manner, and so close to Hogwarts.
Are you all right?
I am, thanks in no small part to your excellent defensive skills. Care to tell me why two Ashwinders were ready to dispatch me to get to you?
Ashwinders?
Victor Rookwood's thieves and extortionists, his little cronies. They seemed quite keen on you.
It's a long story, but thank you for your help.
Well, you've avoided them for the moment. Priya warned me things were getting dangerous. Best get moving on my research before they return.
You're a researcher?
Nora Treadwell at your service, historian and archaeologist specializing in Merlin's work and life.
Merlin? Of the legend of King Arthur?
The very same. Merlin attended Hogwarts, you know, and I'm studying some curious fixtures he left here centuries ago.
Fixtures?
These vine-covered pillars, dozens of them, all around the area. I've taken to calling them the Trials of Merlin. I believe he created them as a diversion for his fellow Slytherins. He was terribly fond of puzzles and enigmas.
I can see why you're so interested in Merlin. I'd be keen to know more about the trials.
Well then, I'll let you in on a little secret. No one has yet managed to figure out how they work. But I believe I have just unlocked a crucial clue. I suspect that mallow sweet is an important component in getting the trials to work.
Mallow sweet?
Versatile herb. Merlin repeatedly mentioned it in his writings. I had just arrived to test my theory when I was so rudely interrupted. You see, each swirl in Merlin's writing has its symbol in the center. That started me thinking, what if...
The mallow sweet is meant to be placed at the center of the symbols.
Precisely. Would you care to do the honors? We can see what comes of our little hypothesis. I brought a trunk chock full of mallow sweet with me. It's just over there by my tent.
This trunk...
Yes, take plenty, even if you already have some.
I have the mallow sweet.
Lovely. Now, notice the vines on these pillars here, as well as a stone swirl on the ground. Each trial has these features. Place the mallow sweet on the swirl, and we'll see what happens. Did you see that? It disappeared.
What should I do now?
This is uncharted territory. I am sure all these pyres.
Accio! Incendio!
The flames make the pyres.
Today, I can hardly believe it.
Revelio.
I take it we can call that a success?
We can indeed. However, I now have even more questions. How does it work? I must review my notes. I may have missed something.
Are all of the trials like this one?
Oh, not precisely. Well, I think each has those telltale vines and the swirl on the ground. You should feel free to solve them as you come across them. I believe I have what I need to continue my research. My guess is that each will also require mallow sweet, which you can find in Hogsmeade should you need more. I really must be off. Such a pleasure to meet you. And do be careful out here. Now I've got what I needed, I shall return to the safety of my notes and books.
Revelio.
Sir Nicholas, our house ghost, is looking for you. You can find him near the Great Hall.
I should investigate.
Revelio.
Hey, it's me, Gareth. Do you have a moment?
Were you calling me, Gareth?
I was. After you helped me with that Fupa feather and potions, I reckoned you might be just the person I need. You see, I have an idea for a fizzing, Wisby-inspired beverage, but I'm missing a key ingredient.
Where do you find time for this and your homework?
I've plenty of time for both. Been managing for years. So, I suspect the key ingredient in fizzing Wisbys is dried billywig stings. I heard there's a store of them in Honeyduke's cellar. I'd get them myself, but my Aunt Matilda has her eye on me. Thinks I need to focus on potions class for a while, not for my own brews. I was hoping you could follow a secret passage to Honeyduke's cellar and grab a few dried billywig stings for me.
Sounds simple enough. And who wouldn't want to go to Honeyduke's?
Ah, brilliant. Thank you. The passage is hidden behind the statue of a one-eyed witch in the third floor corridor. Just tap it with your wand and say, Descendium.
I'll see what I can do, Gareth.
Fair enough. You shall be the first one to taste my newest brew if you can be of help. Perhaps I can convince a meat to help me with my potions homework. Get my aunt to loosen her reins a bit.
You there!
I'll need to get those dried billywigs thing. You wanted to see me, sir?
Yes! Sir Nicholas de Mimsy Porpington. At your service.
Nice to meet you, Sir Nicholas.
I know about the book you found and its missing pages. I may be able to help. Follow me, if you will. It's not too far.
Wait. How do you know about the book? And that it's missing pages?
Word gets around amongst the ghosts. It was spotted with Mr. Sallow in the restricted section. Don't worry. Your secret's safe with me. This may be a leap, but I believe I know who ended up with those pages. I'd be happy to take you to him, if you'd be so kind as to perform a small favor for me along the way.
Revelio.
A small favor in exchange for getting those pages.
Yes, it's nothing really. I'd be grateful if you could simply go into the kitchen and procure a little rotten roast beef.
I beg your pardon. Roast beef. Rotten roast beef.
That is correct. Rotten roast beef. If one floats through it just right, one can almost taste it.
Ugh. I suppose I can do that. But why me?
It's simple, my young friend. My ghostly form cannot carry it. Now, if you'd be so kind as to collect the roast beef, I shall explain everything else in due course. Ah, here we are. Tickle the pear and head on in.
Did you say tickle the pear?
Yes, in the painting. I'll wait right here. Do try not to get it.
Rebellion.
I'm already a bit. Sweet aroma of rotten roast beef.
Our students
never will
in the kitchen.
Students.
What could they want?
Delicious food and want to find themselves a bit peckish, likely.
Certainly, you know, makes Rookie's job easier.
Here's a welcome treat. Delicious. Here's a welcome treat. Delicious.
Revelio.
Ugh, there's a disgusting smell. I must be getting close. Here's some beef, but it's not rotten. I'd best keep looking.
Oh, a student? What a treat! What can Finky get for you? A pumpkin pasty? Perhaps some Welsh rabbit?
Sounds lovely, but what I really need is this rotten roast beef.
Sent you, didn't he? Please help yourself. Finky supposes Nick's tired of loitering about simply to experience the faintest memory of the taste of food.
Do you and the other house elves conjure the food served in the Great Hall?
Goodness, no. Not even house elves can conjure food out of thin air. Food is one of the five principal exceptions to Gamp's law of elemental transfiguration. We can, however, multiply it, transform it, and of course, prepare it. Then we send it straight up to the Great Hall.
Are there any restrictions as to what you can make here?
Finky supposes not. However, Finky has had the best luck with the many recipes left by Helga Hufflepuff. Her quince pie has always been a favourite, but the newfangled Arbro Smokies are becoming popular as well.
Is it all right for students to wander into the kitchens?
Well, since you asked, students aren't supposed to be in the kitchens. But Finky doesn't mind. There's nothing that lifts Finky's spirits more than the company of students. We so rarely get visitors, and we have plenty of treats. Come back any time you please.
It was nice to meet you. Thank you for the beef.
Happy to help, and to meet you as well. Please give Nick Finky's regards.
Who knew all of this was going on right beneath our feet?
Ah, you're back! No trouble, I take it?
Not at all. Finky sends her regards, along with the rotten roast beef.
Ah, glad to hear it. Kind elf, Finky. Now, let's get that beef to Sir Patrick Delaney Podmore, and you'll be one step closer to finding those pages.
This is all rather cryptic, Sir Nicholas. What's going on?
Terribly sorry, I'm getting ahead of myself. Sir Patrick organises the Headless Hunt, a group of headless ghosts who gather for various, headless activities.
Headless activities?
Yes, you'll see. Anyway, I don't know how, but a member of that hunt, Richard Jackdaw, had the pages when he was alive. My plan is to take the rotten roast beef to Sir Patrick so that he'll allow me, us, to engage with the hunt and speak to Jackdaw. Shall we?
I thought the rotten roast beef was for you.
It is, in a way. You see, I've been trying to gain access to the hunt for quite some time. Offering the beef to Patrick may help me in that regard. While, of course, also helping you.
What am I supposed to do when we meet the hunt?
Allow me to do the talking. They can be a rather supercilious lot. I'm certain they'll be welcoming to you, however, in no small part due to the rotten roast beef you will come bearing.
Is the headless hunt dangerous?
Oh, the headless hunt wouldn't hurt a fly, let alone a student. Just a group of fun-loving headless ghosts.
Very well. I'd like to meet Sir Patrick myself and see this headless hunt.
Ah, wonderful. You won't regret it.
You can only see me now.
Do stay behind me. It's Sir Patrick we want.
Oi, Nesta, look who's here.
What have we told you, nearly headless Nick?
Hello, Sir Amzet. Do let us pass. We brought a little something for Sir Patrick.
Probably come to try to beg his way in again.
Do they always talk to you like that?
Ah, all in good fun. Once Sir Patrick lets me join the headless hunt, I'll be right there with them. This offering is sure to win him over.
Don't forget why I'm here, sir.
Rest assured, you'll have your information from young Jackdaw in no time. Wherever he may be.
What I'd give for a flagon of mead or a nice leg of lamb right about now. Then this party would be complete.
How about the next best thing, Sir Patrick?
Ah, Sir Nicholas. And a student. Who let you in?
We brought you a gift.
This is all very suspicious. What do you really want? As if I need to ask.
It's Richard Jackdaw. Where can we find him? May we speak to him?
Jackdaw, eh? Why, here he is now. What a shame. Without his head. I bet you've always wondered what that's like, eh, Nick?
sir, you jest.
It's bound to be around here somewhere. Probably being used in a game. If you find it, I give you my permission to speak with him, my young mortal. It's the least I can do for you for bringing this putrescent gift home.
Sir, there's another matter I wish to discuss with you, if I may.
Tut-tut, Sir Nicholas. How many times do I have to tell you? Our entry requirements are quite clear.
But, sir,
we aren't the headless except for a little bit of tendon hunt, after all. Now, please, follow me and I shall help you find your way out.
Farewell, my young friend. Perhaps your luck with these chaps will be better than mine.
I'd say he's in over his head this time.